The Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes, The Case of the Rose Tattoo is a third-person graphic adventure game from 1996, developed by Mythos Software and published by Electronic Arts. It was the second and unfortunately the last Holmes game in a series, whose first part was the critically acclaimed Case of the Serrated Scalpel from 1992. The Rose Tattoo is set in London in 1889. In the beginning of the game, Sherlock receives a message from his brother Mycroft, whom he and Dr. Watson are supposed to meet at the Diogenes Club.
Thank you, Mrs. Hudson. You are a treasure.
When the two are about to enter the club, a strong explosion inside throws them off their heels. Luckily, Holmes and Watson withstand the blow unscathed, in contrary to Mycroft, who has been heavily injured. Sherlock is devastated, locks himself in his room, and refuses to investigate.
What might I do for you, Holmes? How may I help?
Make yourself scarce, Doctor. If I'm to grow fonder of you, your absence is required.
Allegedly, the explosion was caused by a gas leak, but Watson believes otherwise and starts an investigation on his own.
What's the good word, Oggy?
Out alone, are we, Doctor? Like to turn your end to a game?
Oh, I don't really feel up to it.
Watson, only after having uncovered some clues, can eventually persuade the master detective to lead the investigation, of which the explosion is just the beginning.
Come, Watson. Come. The game is afoot.
It's time we made a move, Watson.
Carry on, Holmes. I'll follow your lead.
The Case of the Rose Tattoo is a very long and complex game. It is mostly non-linear, which means the player really has to think like a detective, trying to uncover the countless mysteries this case bears. Some loose ends can also turn out to be dead ends. During the investigation, more and more places are accessible on the map, which you can roam freely. While in the new Holmes games by Frogwares, Watson is kind of useless, just standing in your way or scaring you to bits, in The Rose Tattoo, dialogues with your partner are essential. John always has some comments about the investigation, offering clues that will lead the player in the right direction.
What would you recommend as a course of action, Watson?
I'd follow my instincts, but I won't waste my breath endorsing that path to you. Don't despair of your own methods now.
Between the two of us, Doctor, there are occasions when feeling may serve us better than rational thought.
Unlike many other adventure games, the focus of The Rose Tattoo lies much more on dialogues, observing your surroundings and spotting small details than puzzle solving. During a playthrough, you will encounter some mini-games such as analyzing and mixing substances on Holmes's table or playing a game of darts in the pub. For its time, the game looks exceptionally neat. The characters are played by real actors who were filmed against the blue screen. What I liked perhaps most of all were the voiceovers. The voices of Holmes and Watson are excellent and add a lot of surface to the atmosphere of the game. For non-English native speakers, it can be sometimes hard to understand, as the language used is quite posh and elaborate, which fits to a plot set in the late 19th century.
You find the woman in the painting beautiful, Watson.
Very lovely. I'm smitten.
Control yourself. Note the wedding ring. Mrs. Silverbridge, I shouldn't wonder.
One may admire without wishing to possess.
Your pardon, Doctor.
One of the few downsides I've found with this game is the handling of the inventory and the overall slow pace. But once you got used to that and are caught in the case, this doesn't matter so much anymore. Also, it is very picky about observation in order to gather new information, so be sure to click on every possible hotspot, maybe several times. The Case of the Rose Tattoo cannot be finished in a few hours, it will take days or maybe weeks to bring it to a satisfying ending. It is authentic, tough and captivating. With its pace, difficulty and its non-linearity, this game is the perfect antithesis to many contemporary games, which focus on cosmetics rather than on a good and solid plot. The Case of the Rose Tattoo is unfortunately not available on Steam or on good old games, so you would have to acquire it from elsewhere. It runs easily on modern systems as it is compatible with Scum VM. The second part of the Lost Files of Sherlock Holmes series is a gem of the mid-90s and seems to have been a bit forgotten. However, compared to its flaws, the game has so much more to offer, which makes it, in my opinion, to one of the best adventure games ever written.
I don't see there's anything very funny about it. If all you can do is laugh at me, well, I can go elsewhere.
No, Mr. Wilson, please, please sit down. I wouldn't miss this case for the world.